aliens come down to Earth, who is the one person you would choose to represent all of humanity? My hospital's chief of neurosurgery. He knows everyone. Orderlies. Evs. Nutrition. All of the nurses and the techs. He's never too busy to say hi to anyone. Call me my first name. He knows all of his patients. Their families. Tells them to call him anytime. Amazingly skilled surgeon and doctor. He will go to funerals. And he's a fucking genius. Started a brain tumor repository to share information all around the world and try to help people. He would be our best human representation. I like it. This is the kind of answer I was looking for, thinking of. A smart, kind, competent, personable person with experience making live or die decisions and weighing risk versus benefit. My neighbor Anne. She's just a really pleasant person. I know you wanted a person, but I choose a golden retriever. The guy around the corner from my house. Guy's always in his front yard chatting up any people that come by. Everyone always leaves his house with small bags of oregano too. Great guy. Edit. Holy shit, this blew up. Thanks for the silvers. My first awards, red heart. Edit 2. Didn't think my comment would blow up like this. Also my first golden, much appreciated. I'll remember you forever. My neighbor is very similar, but he is always giving away little bags of sugar. Since they came to me, I'd just say that it's me. I'd say, hey there. What brings you to our planet? We may need a helping hand in a few areas. Would you be willing to help? If an intelligence that can travel the galaxy but we haven't even been able to detect yet. If they're bent on harming or subjugating us. We're not going to be able to stop them. Let's keep it real. I read this in Korg's voice. There's no other way to think about this guy but Korg now. Jacob. My friend's stepdad. He's built like a happy meatball. And can chat you up for 10 minutes while you're laughing for the entire conversation. I love that you chose a typical person in your life and not a famous or wealthy person. I think people forget that just because someone is well known by the people doesn't make them a guaranteed person to do something for the world. David Attenborough. Someone who can speak their language. Edit. It seems a lot of you want Mark Zuckerberg to be our spokesperson. Are you sure this is a good idea? Where's that actor from Arrival? Patrick Stewart. I mean, he probably still has the uniform. And the aliens be like, OMG, they sent Pikra. Mr. Rogers. Just lock them in a room and show them videos of him. Edit. Holy heck. Thanks for the awards and likes. What if he was an alien? He was over the top nice and truly remarkable. Maybe you just locked them in a room and showed them a video of their great uncle. Myself. Not because I'm self-centered. I just figured it was time I got off my ass and did something. So yeah, if they come, just hit me up and I'll be there. If I am the chosen ambassador, I am gonna teach the aliens how to do jello shots and smoke crack. 4. Science? Not that she would accept. But Dolly Parton. She has always displayed the best balance of entertaining, cleverness, motivation, selflessness and political awareness that I've seen across the board. Edit. Wow. So this is how RIP my inbox feels. Thanks for the awards. Kind strangers. All hail Dolly. Mr. Bean. And no, I don't mean Rowan Atkinson. I mean Mr. Bean. Lot of uncomfortable silence at that meeting. I'd do it for $3.50. And it was about that time I realized this Girl Scout was about 8 stories tall. Jackie Daytona. Regular human bartender. Mark Zuckerberg, they lick their eyeball. He licks his eyeball. That guy's dead wife. She may be dead in life. But she's alive and well amongst Reddit. She will be for eternity. Why is everyone choosing actors? Top reply right now is the oregano guy. If he were still alive. Mr. Rogers himself. Hands down. Dot. Won't you be my neighbor? Weird Al Yankovic. Because if anyone can bridge the gap between humans and aliens, it's him. Some guy with severe disabilities, so they underestimate us and we win the coming war. I was gonna say an infant, but this works too. Danny DeVito. Edit. Thanks for the award. Oh no, I dropped my monster condom that I use for my magnum dong. That guy who was in that movie with the other guy from that show I like. But that other guy would be better. Sigourney Weaver. Duh. A perfect answer. Can they be living or dead? BC Steve Irwin. Crikey. Would you take a look at that alien? I'm gonna touch it. Sadly, Carl Sagan isn't with us anymore. They didn't upload his conscience? Fuck. We're screwed. Carl Sagan. Morgan Freeman. Without a question. Jane Goodall. Perhaps the best choice. A regular diplomat would only be competent with human interactions. A behavioral biologist would understand the need to fundamentally reevaluate communication for a different species. Dolly Parton would be a solid person, I would say. She chill. Mark Rebellet. If anyone can make aliens dance, it would absolutely be the Loop Daddy himself. Stephen Fry. Mark Zuckerberg. He'd probably recognize a couple of them. Also, he's the most expendable. Rick Astley. So that their first impression of Earth is just being Rickrolled. It's 2027. Alien spaceship hovering over what they identify as the center of our world's power, a McDonald's restaurant. World powers convey in the restaurant car park. Massive speakers ready to blare out Rick Astley's Never Gonna Give You Up. After several playthroughs, the aliens leave. Skip to 3 days later. Millions of alien spaceships descend on Earth in an equidistant pattern that spans the entire globe. In a gesture of friendship and communication, the spaceships play the song repeatedly for 4 months. With a sound range enough to cover all the distance in between each spaceship, the world is now essentially a giant Bluetooth speaker blaring out Never Gonna Give You Up on repeat. Your plan has backfired. Rick Astley is now Universal President. Florida Man. Whatever day the aliens arrive, that date needs to be entered into Google and the Florida Man from the first article will be summoned. Unlimited PBR. Budweiser and Natty will be provided for this meeting. Also freshly extracted from the ass baggie of crystal meth. QP of the finest middies from the city. An old prescription bottle filled to the brim of X. About 7 grams of fentanyl-laced heroin W, the brand new never used for drugs spoon he stole from the thrift store. A 2-liter Mountain Dew and 9 rocks from Jerry on MLK Boulevard. Myself. I trust no one. Gordon Ramsay. I will not explain my thinking. But it would be funny for multiple reasons. You want to see the world burn. Don't you? Bob Ross. Fuck it. Jeff Goldblum. I feel like he'd have some great stories to tell them. And he'd be super interested in anything they have to say as well. So long as they introduce him as the Grandmaster exactly the same way he's introduced in the movie. Prepare yourself. Dave Grohl. No reason except that he is exceptionally charismatic. Weird Al, definitely. My father-in-law. Fair and just and a person of his word into death. Most trustworthy person I ever met. Hans Zimmer. Interstellar full soundtrack. Full orchestra. Wouldn't make much sense sending someone with a language, really. Better to communicate in frequencies. That dude who keeps pulling napkins out from under other objects and stares at the camera all crazy. David Tennant. Neil Gaiman. I feel like he would know what to say. In an ideal world, Steve Irwin. Betty White. Paul Rudd. He's funny, pleasant-faced, and seems like he could make enough fun, light-hearted chit-chat to get us through any first encounter awkwardness. Wikipedia. Henry Winkler.